BookTV recently visited Capitol Hill to ask members of Congress what they're reading this summer.
Well, I just finished reading A Spy Among Friends, which is a spectacular true story of Kim Philby, who was the greatest counter-espionage spy in the history of the world. He was head of counterintelligence for Great Britain, but in fact he was a double agent for the Soviet Union. And it's a terrific story about the whole world of espionage and intelligence. As a member of the House Permanent Select Committee on Intelligence, I take particular interest in this kind of thing. I've also just finished reading Killers of the Flower Moon, The Osage Murders and the Beginning of the FBI, which is the true story of how the Osage Indians in Oklahoma were tremendously exploited and in fact systematically murdered in order to gain access to their mineral rights. What I'm about to read, because as of November 6th of this year, the starting gun will go off for the 2020 presidential elections. So we're all gonna be treated to books by the various candidates for President of the United States. I've got The Right Answer by John Delaney. Now, John happens to be a colleague of mine. He came into the U.S. House in the same class I did. He's from Maryland, but he's retiring, as it were, in order to run for president. And this is the first of, I'm sure, many of books by presidential candidates that I'll be reading before the next 2 years is up. This is entitled The Right Answer, and it's taken from a speech by John Kennedy. Again, this is the first of presidential candidate books I'm sure that I'll read over the next 2 years. Couple of my favorite chestnuts that I'm hoping I'll have chance to read over the course of the summer, two of my favorite books of all time, The Name of the Rose by Umberto Eco. He's an Italian intellectual and academic who sprung onto the international scene in the early 80s with a terrific book. It takes place in a 14th century Italian abbey, and Brother William of Baskerville is a monk who's brought in to investigate allegations of heresy. But before things get fully developed and he reaches his conclusion, there are something like six or seven murders. It's a terrific book, and it was an international bestseller. And then, of course, probably my favorite book of all time, To Kill a Mockingbird by Harper Lee, which was published in 1960 and made into that great film in 1962 starring Gregory Peck, starring one of my favorite actors, by the way, Robert Duvall, in his film debut role as Boo Radley. It was written, the adaptation of Harper Lee's terrific book, by Horton Foote, who also wrote my favorite movie of all time, maybe, Tender Mercies, which also starred Robert Duvall. But this is an interview about books, and I'm hoping that I'll be able to get back to reread To Kill a Mockingbird, which will be my seventh or eighth time reading it. And that's my summer reading.
BookTV wants to know what you're reading. Send us your summer reading list at BookTV on Twitter, Instagram, or on Facebook. BookTV on C-SPAN 2, television for serious readers.